Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to a brand new video, brand new week, brand new trade. So this week I looked at three P's, as you can see on the right side. I looked at Euro USD, New Zealand USD and GBP JPY. So the chart that I have in front of me is Euro USD, and I'm just gonna speak you through it, through the analysis of what I saw and the reason to why I took that trade. So let's just get rid of that bar over there to create more space for us to work with. So I'm not gonna go to the 4 hour and the daily time frame now. I'll just explain from the structure that you see now, and then I'll take it from there, and then hopefully you'll understand. So obviously, let me just get rid of this bar here. Okay, so now that bar's out of the way. So what we're looking at currently is, obviously this is a higher time frame structure, the trend lines that are in there. So you will see it's the one and then the two and then the third touch over there. And then if you look here on the bottom trend line, we have 1, 2, and then obviously we approached that third touch. I think before I took this trade here, the market was, let's just zoom in a bit so that I can explain better, and just move this across so that you can actually get to the trade where the trade took place. And obviously the most important thing while trading, the strategy that I do, is that we look at current price action. So we don't look for, we look just here, we look what the market tells us, and we perform from that structure there. So obviously, let's just get this tool over here. Can see that the market came in this area over here where the trend line was, and for me, I had two things in mind. It's either we get a third touch there, we move up a bit, and then, or we wait, have the market do its correction there, and then wait for that pierce through. So obviously, also keeping in mind that I knew on the higher time frame, on the 4 hour and the daily time frame, that the bias is to the downside. So obviously we had this touch here. You can see that the market went up a bit there, a bit correctively. And then what I was basically waiting for, as I said earlier, was that break where the market just breaks the trend line. And it's not that it breaks, it's how it breaks. So obviously, like you can see, the market broke that trend line impulsively. So the first thing I looked for was that impulsive break, and right after that impulsive break, what I then look for is the hover. So the most important thing is that there over there, that correction over there. So the first correction after the break is what we look for, and you can basically see, I'll just zoom in a bit just to give you that picture there. So this is what you're looking at. Let me just move this a bit here. So that's what you're looking at over there. So you can see once it broke that channel over there, that short channel, we knew that it's time to put in those cells. And you can basically see that the sell was put in, and obviously the target that I was looking for was this target over here, and that target is known as the 90% rule, basically, because you can see that the market completes 90% of the structure that was previously made. So if you look at this channel over here, you'll see that this is the start of the channel here, and right there it broke me, and then it came to this area here. So totally happy with this trade here. Went to did exactly what my strategy allowed me to do. I followed all the rules and the outcome was perfect, as you can see there. So I'm totally happy with how this trade played out. And yeah, I think the next two trades will also have a look at that, which was GBP JPY and New Zealand JPY, that was to look at. So if you enjoyed this video, guys, if you enjoyed the breakdown of this analysis as to why I took the sell, feel free to like the video and feel free to hit the subscribe button. I'll speak to you guys on the next videos.